We have several PCBs here, and many companies use a single bridge rectifier to convert AC to DC. You can see here that a single bridge rectifier is also used, but some brands use double rectification. So why does this happen? For example, this is from Sharp, and they use double rectification. And this is from O-General, this one is from Gree, and this one is from Aux. So why are two bridge rectifiers used? Today I will give you full information about this. This technology is called modulation. You see, this is an IPM. So modulation is also happening here, but it is a bit different, and a different system is used here. So first of all, I will explain to you what modulation is. Our main topic will be pulse amplitude modulation. First of all, the important thing to understand is what modulation is. Modulation is a very large subject, and it's difficult to explain everything in a short video. Therefore, we will limit ourselves to a few parameters, specifically focusing on the two bridge rectifiers, and we'll talk accordingly. But first, let me give you a brief idea of what modulation is. The electricity we have comes in the form of a sinusoidal wave, which carries voltage, frequency, and current. These three things travel together. When we bring changes to any of these, for example, if we talk about current, it has amplitude, which is its height. If we change its height, width, or frequency, that is called modulation. So that is the simple definition of modulation. Now let's look at the types of modulation. We can't cover everything, but our main topic will be analog modulation. And within analog modulation, we will talk about PAM, which is pulse amplitude modulation. That will be our focus today. So what is amplitude? I will explain it in terms of electricity, because that's our topic. When sinusoidal waves are flowing, there is a midpoint called the zero point. Now, if I draw lines here, the distance between the lines is called amplitude, meaning its length. Now, let's move on to pulses. Normally, when a person checks their pulse, they feel the pulse rate when they put their hand on their wrist. They also feel their pulses coming and going on their wrist. This reflects the natural rhythm of electrical pulses in a circuit. Similarly, when we talk about electricity, sinusoidal waves are coming in, and current is flowing with it. When we turn the pulse on, you can see that one waveform is generated, and it has a time period, meaning it stays on for a specific time and then turns off. When we turn it off, it goes into the off position, and that becomes our off position. Then we keep it off for a certain period, and then we turn it on again, which generates another pulse. This process continues to generate pulses. Now let's talk about PAM, pulse amplitude modulation, which is achieved by using two rectifiers. In this process, sinusoidal waves carry the current. First, the current is turned on through the IGBT for a specific time period so that the wave can work within its range, which creates a pulse. After that, it is turned off for a specific time and then turned on again, generating another wave. This process continues, keeping the current within the sinusoidal waves. Then, the current is turned off again, and this on-off cycle has a set time period. This on-off switching through the IGBT is called pulse amplitude modulation, PAM. The reason we use two rectifiers is to control the current, which improves the power factor. When the power factor is good, the compressor runs better, has a longer life, and the current flow helps it run more efficiently. So these two rectifiers are used specifically for controlling the current. Now let's talk practically. Look, I have set up the PCB here, and I will turn it on to show you how it functions. I have turned the PCB on, and you can see it's working. The rectifier is directly connected to the capacitors. What happens here is that when AC is converted to DC, the voltage can experience a peak increase due to the rectification process. Here, you can see 328 volts, and this point is connected to the IGBT. In the second bridge rectifier, we observe 215 volts DC, indicating no significant voltage boost, likely due to minimal filtering or boosting. Now, what happens is that current is flowing with the voltage, and the IGBT will control the current by turning it on and off, improving the power factor. There's also a reactor here, which sometimes stores energy and sometimes discharges it, further improving the power factor. This system is used to optimize the current flow to the compressor. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.